Hi, how y'all doing out there? This is Hillbilly Jim. I got an important message to all you little kids. I don't want y'all to cross them streets nowhere but in them crosswalks where you're supposed to, because if you don't, somebody could come along and run over you. Now, be careful. Do this for Hillbilly Jim, and I'll be seeing y'all later. Bye now.
It's sensational.
At 53 pounds, the Samurai Warrior, Mr. Fuji. And his opponent, from Hawaii, weighing 237 pounds, Ricky the Dragon.
Whoa, look out, baby! Ricky's teamboat with Mr. Fuji, whipped to the ropes. Oh, my! And Ricky's teamboat getting Mr. Fuji. Only what's justified, if you'll recall what happened not long ago. Oh, my goodness. Steamboat hanging Mr. Fuji, much like Fuji and Muraco did to Ricky Steamboat not long ago.
Exactly, exactly. And Mr. Fuji's nice getting exactly what's coming to him, because he and Muraco practically hanged Steamboat from the top rope, as everybody well remembers. And boy, Steamboat came in all fired up, and he's here for revenge. And I'll tell you, he's doing a number on Mr. Fuji.
Is he ever? Ah, to the spine.
Oh, brother.
A dragon with a double chop. That was a chop in the lower area, and then from there an uppercut, one to the throat.
You know, when they first started the match, I was about to say, Vince, this should be an interesting bout, because they are both very good in the arts. They're both great karate experts and both good wrestlers. So it'll be interesting what happens. But,
Fuji now measuring with the head.
Those blows that Fuji was using on Steamboat were right to the heart.
Tremendous matchup here. Mr. Fuji versus the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat. And this capacity crowd trying to help Ricky Steamboat come back and take control of the matchup. Fuji digging in. With a chop by the Dragon. Misses. Oh, chop by Fuji in retaliation. Nicely done by Mr. Fuji.
The way Steamboat got started in the beginning of this match, where he was, took the advantage over Fuji, I really thought he might upset him and come up with a real quick victory. But Fuji's shown what he's made out of, because it took quite a bit, and now he's back in there. He's got the upper hand on Steamboat.
Ooh! Chop to the head. Steamboat off the rope, over him, right back at him, missing. Fuji, look at that. Ooh. That was done in such rapid fashion. Fuji really showing that he is indeed a world-class wrestler.
He's a world-class wrestler, and he's a world-class karate expert, as is Steamboat, of course. But Steamboat's got a little more speed. He has more speed than Fuji, and that might come into to his advantage as the match progresses. But we'll see. The people certainly behind him, you know, that's got to help you. When you hear those people chanting your name, that just makes that adrenaline flow and really gives you that extra energy that you need. Although right now it doesn't seem like it. This Steamboat, look at this, look at this. He's very limp.
Steamboat trying to do something to come back. Trying to make a move now. Steamboat with that never say die attitude. Steamboat going downstairs. Oh, and a rake in the face, a chop to the throat. Steamboat trying to set up Mr. Fuji. A whip to the rope coming off. Oh, the top. Steamboat to the outside now, to the top rope. Fuji, Dave spins around, hooks him. Will he get him? One, two.
No. Oh, what a surprise.
Too good to be true. Oh, no.
That's the first time, Vince, I've seen anybody not get pinned from that flying press from Steamboat.
Well, he neglected to hook the leg. Fuji kept his legs down. Look at that maneuver. Package, he may get him. Two, I think. Yes, they did. He got him.
He got him.
A sensational victory. A sensational victory for Ricky Steamboat. And this capacity crowd, all in armor, of this extraordinary athlete.
Here's the winner, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
The Dragon, Ricky Steamboat. Sensational victory. No, no, no. Oh, no, look. Look. It's Muraco. It's Muraco and Fuji.
Oh, brother, look at this. What's he using? Look at this. Look.
He broke a chair over his head.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that. He's spitting on him. He's spitting on Steamboat. Oh, my.
To take away this man's victory like that.
What a dastardly thing.
Muraco running, obviously had been watching the match from the dressing room, running, waiting for Steamboat to turn around to face the ring once again, and then Muraco came running. Steamboat's hurt. Let's see, maybe we have a replay. All right, here now, let's take a look at it.
Here's Steamboat, he's celebrating the victory. He's overjoyed. And look, here comes Muraco from the back now with the chair. Boom, look at him. He busted the chair right on his upper back. And I'll tell you, look at Steamboat. Of course, you didn't even expect it. Now look at this. With the steel part of the chair, he left it right above the throat. Nice spinning on him. I'll tell you, that's a crime. Both Fuji and Muraco should be fined and suspended and everything else that they could do to him. And look at Steamboat now, he's hurt. Oh. He is hurting.
All right.
That's a shame.
Back out to the stunned crowd. And there we saw Ricky Steamboat just before he was defrocked of his victory over Mr. Fuji. And what a sensational victory it was, only to be robbed by Muraco. We'll take you to the interview, and hopefully we'll have some word on...